circumstances. So I'm very pleased to introduce a truly courageous leader. Somebody say courageous, please. Under her stewardship, difficult decisions were made to serve the greater good. This leader was thrust onto the national stage as she tirelessly, and I mean tirelessly, worked with others to secure resources to support Michiganders. This leader seeks to build bridges and bring people together. She views volunteerism and service as key components, as key catalysts to do so. And so tonight is about celebrating people who have gone above and beyond. And I think this leader, and you know who I'm talking about, certainly went above and beyond. And so as it is now time for us all to unite in service to each other, let's start with a warm welcome for our courageous, re-elected
winners have exhibited an extraordinary level of dedication, and generosity and compassion, and their stories are a real testament to the power of volunteerism. These outstanding individuals and businesses and organizations have selflessly given their time, their talent, and their resources to make a real difference in people's lives. So I want to thank each of them for strengthening our communities and making Michigan a better place. So let's get to the good stuff. I want to introduce my partner in governance, Lieutenant Governor Garland Gilchrist. He is a phenomenal public servant and our Lieutenant Governor for 4 more years. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. Would please give Governor Wimper another round of applause. Governor, I am so humbled to serve the entire state of Michigan and all of its people, all of our communities, for another 4 years. And tonight's celebration, a celebration of community, commitment, of compassion, these are values that we all hope to aspire to and demonstrate in our daily walk of life. And the people who step up, the people who serve others, the people who put the good for the community above any kind of selfish interest, that is what makes Michigan such an amazing place. And these service awards are meant to be just one demonstration of our recognition, of our gratitude, and of the debt that we owe to those who sacrifice on behalf of others. Tonight's heroes come from every background. They're representative of communities all across all 83 counties, both peninsulas, and every identity here in Michigan. These are people who saw problems and solved them. People who
Anastasia Garcia, Wafa Haddad, Carl Lindquist of Superior Watershed, Otis Bellman of Building Better Men, Patrice Henderson, Jen Kuhausen, Esther Ladd, Lynn Mills, Erica Owens, Alka Srivastava, and Savita Monroe from Detroit Indian Women's Association, Diana Charlotte, Taisha Turner, Jenny and Matt Sherrill, Alex Van Herring, Mary Zaleski, Bernard Zoot, the GM Project Team, and Calvin Trent. Let's give it up for our heroes. I think I'm trying to give you a little bit tight. We have to give you a tight little bit. So just speak to your left. Slide over a little bit. It's a way to take a picture. Slide over to your left, please. There you go. people up here on stage. How many of you know how humble they are? It seems like the people doing the most want the least attention, but they deserve it. The people doing the least always want the most, but that's another conversation for another day. One more time, let's give it up for our heroes, please. And so these pillars who serve in our communities are foundations. They are, like the great Bob Seger once sang, and as the popular ads remind us, they are like a rock. And here to honor our Civic Engagement and Impact Awards, she is a sincere and sensational singer-songwriter. More than that, I'm proud to say that she's also my friend. She's getting plugged in here to make sure that you all can hear her when she plays a beautiful music. And she is accompanied by Pete Ballard, and she is Allison Lewis.
Thank you.
Standing there boldly, sweating in the sun, felt like a million. I felt like number one. The height of summer, I never felt that strong, like a rock. My hands were steady, my eyes were clear and bright. My walk had a purpose, my steps were quick and light. And I moved firmly to what I felt was right.
Not a dictation, I'm just making sure you're still with us. June Swift has been an inspiration to everyone at Senior Neighbors since 2013, when she began serving as an AmeriCorps foster grandparent at Harrison Park High School. As part of the program, June is only required or asked to serve 6 students per year, but she insists on serving over 20, overachieving. At the program, she has accrued over 7,000 hours of service, and her positive attitude and heartwarming smile are contagious. Youth Work AmeriCorps, Child and Family Services, Northwest Michigan, is a unique AmeriCorps program designed to support young people through the completion of environmental conservation projects. Located within Child and Family Services, Youth Work provides vulnerable children, adults ages 16 to 35, with hands-on job and life skills training while they serve as one of 100 AmeriCorps members. The crews complete various service-based stewardship projects for nonprofit and public partners across Michigan. Representing the organization tonight is Bill Watson. Economic Opportunity Coaching Corps, AmeriCorps, Peckham Incorporated, serves people with disabilities, physical challenges, refugees, and individuals employed by Peckham. AmeriCorps members. you know him, some of you don't, but that is Alvin Wallace. And that man is a world-class musician who just humbly said, I'll be happy and honored to accompany Kisma. And that was powerful. So thank you to Kisma. Thank you, Alvin, for blessing us tonight. Can we give it up to him one more time? Thank you for let us break bread together. Now, what does it take for us to even have that bread?